What's up guys, welcome to the Life Hacks channel, and today in this tutorial I'll be showing you how to make the Windows based PC operating system, okay, that your computer runs smoother or boosting your PC. So firstly, you're gonna need is program called CCleaner right here, and I have provided the link in description so you guys can download and install it easily. So after installing it, let's get started right now. So let's open the CCleaner first, and on the Windows section you have to be analyzing the junk file. It will scan for the junk file, and then you need to do is a run cleaner. Then this will clean your PC. It will remove all the junk files, whatever you don't need it. It will take some time. Alright, it's cleaning right now. Okay, it removed me a 629 megabyte. And let's scan for the application 2. It's about the 5 MB. I'm using the Internet Explorer right now. So let's run the cleaner. Now it will remove the 5 MB too. Okay, so you can see it's removed 6.1 MB. So it removed all the caches, so now my computer must be a little much snappier. Also, we're gonna register, we're gonna fix the register. Okay, scan for the issues. It will scan, it will take 1 minute for the first scan on a computer, so be patient. It's scanning. Alright, let's fix it. Yes, I want to. Okay, this for this tutorial I don't want to. Okay, and fix all selected issue and it will fix it and close. Now no issue to be found. So let's move to the tool section. Then you can find the uninstall and remove program. So if you guys want to uninstall from here, then you can do from here too. Also, you can repair the software or program. Also, you can rename. And if you guys are having trouble to uninstalling, then you can directly delete from here. So it make you easy to do that. So also, before you do something taking action from here, you must save the text file so that you will know what you have installed in your PC. So save the text, and you have to save. Okay, let me save my desktop install, and let me show you what it so it will be looking at. Let me show from the notepad. Okay, it showed me like Adobe and blah blah blah. It will show you the installed software on the date and everything. So it will save the data. Okay, so let's move to the startup. So what you can do here is press on enable first. You will be sorted by no and yes. No means disable, and S means enable. So if you guys want to something disable or enable from here, you can just do it on disable and enable. But I won't recommend you guys to do on the Windows, because this is the system. If you're gonna do a disable and enable on Windows, you're gonna ruin your computer, so don't do it. Let's move to Internet Explorer, and you can do it here. So I have done everything. I don't need to use it. So I have disabled the IDMN and bitcommit and the Firefox. I need all, and the Google Chrome. Just click on the enable and it will sort you with the yes and no. Also, it will sort you the app and extension plugin. So whatever you don't need, just just click it and disable from here too. Whoops, burden extension browser it. Sorry for this guys. So and you don't need to do from here anything, and schedule tax and context menu. Now move on to disk analyzer, and you guys need to do is analyze your disks, so you can do it, compress email and everything and analyze it. But I'm not gonna doing it because I have already done before this tutorial. So let's move on to duplicator finder. This is the very good tool to search your duplicate files. So let's search for the local .dixf. It will find me a duplicate file, and so it will also make me easy to find the duplicate files and original files. So you can see that it showed me a tons of duplicates. Oops. Alright. So click on the, if you don't want to want a boot file, then you can click on just one. This, like this, and this. Delete this selected file. Okay. Then yes, it has been deleted. So this is how you delete the file. So I have the many files, but I will not be deleting it just in this tutorial. Let's go to the system restore point. So don't remove it. Okay, don't remove it. If you're gonna remove it, you're gonna lost your restore checkpoint. So don't perform this activities, because someday you're gonna damage your operating system. Now you need to restore the point. So you have deleted, then there will be no checkpoint for you. So don't do this, and also don't wipe your space. You're gonna ruin your hard drive sometime. So running her, don't do this. It will erase data too. So also you can upgrade to the pro if you want to see cleaner. I have been just starting from a free trial. You can go to website from here too. Let's close this now. The advanced setting I will be showing you. Just hit the Windows and R, then it will pop up the run. Then here we gotta be typing is msconfig. So it will show you the system configuration. So you can go to the services. Okay, it will show you the services and check on the status. It will sort by running and stop it. Okay, so let's disable something what I don't need. Is I don't need is here. Let's check it started. I don't need is a Kinoni service and the mobile in service. It's a mobile and my waffle service. And check all the whatever you don't need and press apply and reboot your PC once, then it will work for you guys. And startup tools, let's open the task manager, right? So you can disable from here too, or from the C cleaner too. So I want to disable from here, this one. Okay, it's been disabled. And this is the Acrobat Reader Manager. I want to enable it. So enabling and disabling is very easy from here too. So and press OK. So it will ask you to restart a PC, but I'm not going to do it because I want to show you more. So let's open the PC and click on properties. If your computer is running still slow, then go to the my computer and click on properties. Okay, and go to your advanced setting from here. Yeah, go to the advanced and performance system. And for the old computers, you can use the adjust for the best performance or adjust for the best performance. Okay, this one, or you can do manually tick and do something here like that, but I will not be using that. But I want this. So advanced, you gotta be choosing the programs. Because if you gotta choose the background, then the program you are using, it will lag, or sometimes it will make a hang on a computer. So choose on the program if you have been choosing the background services. This is highly recommended. Okay, so next is the personal memory right here, as you guys can see. So we have to change it. So change and customize it. So let me come back to here, this step. As you see, my system has installed RAM is a 4 GB. So personal memory in this stage, we have to give double of the 4 gig. So 4 gigabyte double, it's 8 gigabyte. Okay, so we have to give it a megabyte, so it's 8,000. Okay, you can set the board at 8,000 and set it and press OK, and it will be setting up the 8,000 megabyte. Alright, program not responding. It will be setting up. Okay, mine is set up the memory. So now you can see that initial memory and maximum memory. It's 800, not 800, sorry, it's 8,000 and it's also 8,000. Okay, and press OK again and close it out. Then finally, you gotta do is power and restart the computer.